The Newshour Special Edition.
Good evening and welcome to the News. I'm Madhavdas Gopalakrishnan. The story that we're going to be discussing on the show today is an explosive inside story of what was going on in the Congress party 24 hours before counting day. What was going on in the minds of Rahul Gandhi? What were the people who are the closest to him, his closest advisors, telling him? Were they leading him up the garden path? That's a question that we'll certainly be debating. But first, a look at the headlines. All right. It is, in fact, the story that we are debating at this point of time. Clearly, of course, questions being raised about whether Rahul Gandhi, who is now, in fact, offered to resign as the Congress president, while the Modi government, in fact, has gotten down to running its business in the Mazboot Sarkar 2.2, Congress is still grappling in the dark and introspecting what led to their loss. However, a News Weekly has seemed to have figured it all out. A news report in the Sunday Guardian reveals how Rahul's own team led him down the garden path and completely miscalculated how the party would fare in the elections. The report states that the Congress president was made to believe that his party will form the government and that the party would bag anywhere between 164 to 184 seats. Take a look at this report.
On May 23rd, Rahul Gandhi's worst nightmare came true. His party's tally was the second worst in its century-old history. What's worse was that Rahul was caught completely off guard. As per the Sunday Guardian, the Congress president was led to believe that the party was set to secure 180-plus seats in the election. His close aides gave him hopes that he could be the Prime Minister of the country.
They were relying on people whose credentials were not proven. You know, you don't rely in politics or in elections on data analysts or people who provide you data. You know, you should have a mechanism to understand the ground reality and to get feedback from your own workers and your own, you know, party. They were totally misled and they proved to trust, they were very gullible and they trusted these characters more than what they should have.
This election has been one of errors for the Congress party, from predicting an unreal seat share to drawing up a list of potential winners. Two letters to stake claim to the government were written. The Congress party even readied a list of prominent leaders for the new cabinet, allies were contacted and berths were offered. Ashok Gehlot, Kamal Nath and Akhilesh Yadav completely misjudged ground reality and overestimated the number of seats they would win.
The Congress party and its leadership, the family, is trying to blame everybody else for the defeat, but are not willing to own responsibility for having led the Congress party to this disastrous result.
The Gandhi family was misled by several of Rahul's aides. Four out of the eight people working in the Congress president's office have resigned, and others are off the grid.
Praveen Chakravarti, who heads the data analytics department in the Congress party, is known to be very close to Rahul Gandhi. And in fact, he was the one who said that somewhere between 167 to 180 seats is what the Congress is going to be getting in this elections. But clearly, that was not the case.
Priyanka Gandhi too failed to make an impact. Her Uttar Pradesh campaign completely failed. She was adamant on not contesting Varanasi, and that put a spanner in Rahul's Uttar Pradesh plans. Congress's Lok Sabha route is a reminder for the grand old party to regroup and introspect. But has this new report proved that the Congress under a gullible Rahul is completely out of sync with reality? Bureau Report, Times Now.
You're watching the NewsHour Special Edition, Debate Number 1 on Times Now, Super Prime Time.
We're joined live by Neha Joshi, spokesperson of the BJP from a Noida studio. Also with us here in our studio is Shehzad Poonawala, lawyer, joining us. Ravi Srivastav, political analyst, joins us from Mumbai. Also with us on the broadcast is Alimuddin Khan, political analyst. Let me begin with you, Ravi Srivastav. This report, you know, what it seems to suggest, and very clearly, of course, what it is pointing out to, is that the closest advisors of Rahul Gandhi were completely misleading him. Even 24 hours before counting, they had no idea of the kind of result that they were actually looking at. One can understand if one gets it wrong 20%, 30%, 50%, but not one third of what the actual outcome is.
Yeah, Madhav, let me tell you that it's not only those advisors, the close advisors who have failed Rahul Gandhi. The fact is that in the first address after the elections, I think Rahul Gandhi himself said that he was under tremendous pressure from these chief ministers who were lobbying for the ticket of their sons and wards and all that, and they were pressurizing him. So I don't say that this report I have read, but I am saying that the Rahul Gandhi is not so naive that he would have believed them with the closed eyes and all that, but he must have known that somewhere something is definitely missing.
Sir, if he was not so naive, let me ask you a simple question, sir. Let me ask you a simple question. Ravi Shivastav, I'm not going to get into the debate of, you know, pressure coming in from various chief ministers and top leaders. I'm going to let the BJP spokespersons respond to you on that. But my question to you is very simple, that if he was indeed, you know, so clearly in control of the situation, where is Mr. Praveen Chakravarti today? Where is Divya Spandana today? She has deleted her entire social media profiles and she's a social media chief of the party. What's going on?
I told you, before you could tell me, I am telling you that they have vanished. The Chakravarti has totally vanished. Divya Spandana has deactivated her account. And it is also said in the news, in the report itself, that she was charging something around 8 crore rupees for running the campaign for the Congress party.
For so what were these 8 crore rupees being charged?
Something has gone seriously wrong. I mean, that is what every party does it. Somebody appoints Prashant Kishore, somebody appoints somebody else. The people are spending money. The BJP spent 27,000 crore on their campaign. Can you ask them that who all they have paid for what?
Okay.
And how much have they paid?
Okay.
It's not
okay.
A question that who paid what. The
okay, Neha Joshi wants to respond to you on that.
She misled the complete campaign.
Neha Joshi, do you find it amazing that today, you know, after the horses have literally bolted from the stable, post-mortem is still going on in the Congress party. Nobody knows what's going on. Not the senior leaders, not Mr. Rahul Gandhi himself, not those who are very closely associated with him. Even they seem to have run away today.
Absolutely. You know, Rahul Gandhi is missing in action right now. We saw Priyanka Gandhi. You know, he hasn't visited Amethi, a place that he claimed loved him immensely. And, you know, he gave all that pyar ka gyan. Aur aaj Amethi harne ke baad wapas tak nahi gaye ek baar logon ko dhanyawad karne ke liye. Priyanka Gandhi, we saw what she did in Rae Bareli. She blamed the ground level workers for not doing enough. So that's the kind of gesture that you see from the party general secretary in charge of those very seats. However, you know what the gentleman before me was saying. Divya Spandana was an official office bearer of the party. She wasn't a professional like Prashant Kishore. BJP may have hired Prashant Kishore or XYZ agency to do some bit of the advertising part. Amit Malviya is an office bearer. He is an office bearer of the party.
What
so, you know, to compare those two, let me,
madam,
Neha Joshi is a spokesperson
aware.
Of the BJP.
2014,
she doesn't get paid to
Prashant
appear.
Kishore was managing.
So, you know, you have to know the difference. There is a party cadre,
don't
there
say,
is a Sangathan.
For it.
And, you know, this whole thing shows that in Congress, it's just about the money.
But
there is
Prashant
no Sangathan.
Kishore is
there is no organization.
Advisor.
Because for an organization, you need a leader. Where is the leader? The leaders have scored it right now.
Okay.
Please don't
okay.
say that.
Okay.
Don't
okay.
say that
okay.
everybody hires people and
okay.
pays money.
Okay. 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 Shehzad Punawala.
As somebody who's actually spent time in the Congress and I guess nobody else on the panel has, and as somebody who has raised these issues consistently, let me bring out two or three facts. Point number one, you can't say today, you know, I want to pick a bone with you. Rahul has not been misled, Madhav. To do that is to actually give credit to Rahul ki yaar baki sab logon ne usko milke bewakoof banaya. You know, to lead a party like the Congress, you need to be a decision maker who leads from the front. Modi can't say that Amit Shah ne mere ko bewakoof bana diya, Dharmendra Pradhan ne bewakoof bana diya. Modi is the leader, he'll take the decisive decision. So Rahul Gandhi has to own up. Point
okay.
number one. Point number two.
Important
see,
point, yes.
Point number two. Forget Divya and Praveen Chakravarti, unhone chuna laga ke aur nikal gaye. Rahul Gandhi ne kya sudhar kiya? Just imagine, Rahul Gandhi has repeated the same script. You all showed it in Wayanad. He went and said, Pradhan Mantri Modi zehar phaila rahe. Not gone to Amethi. His mother has blamed EVMs. His sister has blamed the poor karyakartas. And they are blaming people of India. They are blaming everybody, including the fingers of the voters. But they are not taking the blame on themselves.
Yes.
Thirdly, Just 1 second, for just entertainment value. What entertainment value? This is the statement of Shri Shri, and I have to add two Shris for Praveen Chakravarti. We have done our survey and analysis across the country. BJP, I do not see BJP winning a single state in 2019 of the large states they won in 2014. UP, Maharashtra, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Gujarat, Haryana, Delhi, which is why I term the 2014 victory as a black swan event.
Okay.
If anybody is relying on this kind of crap, that guy does
I want to bring in Alimuddin Khan on this. Alimuddin Khan, one second, Ravi Shwastha, before you come in, I want to bring in Alimuddin Khan also in this debate. Alimuddin Khan, you know, somewhere or the other, Rahul Gandhi will have to take the blame. Because even if it is these people who have cheated him, he is the one who appointed them in the first place. He is the president of the Congress party.
See, Madhavji, please give me some time. I want little time. In your last debate, you have hardly given me time. I want to say Congress mistake number one was that not highlighting Indraji's and Rajivji's achievements before elections.
Sir, we are discussing media. Rahul Gandhi,
mistake
we are discussing how far back in history are we going to go.
We should have highlighted the freedom struggle.
Please answer the question.
He did not say Manmohan Singh ji's achievements.
We are having a serious discussion here. Alimuddin Khan, very serious question to you, sir. Shouldn't Rahul Gandhi take the blame? Because ultimately, he was the Congress president during the 2019 Lok Sabha polls.
King can do no wrong.
See, Madhavji, Rahul Gandhiji has taken responsibility and he has already resigned. And everybody knows
his
about
Twitter
it.
His Twitter handle says
so
he's
what
the president.
So, what more you want to say about it?
He's the president. He's taking meetings, administrative also.
Okay, continue, Alimuddin Khan, continue. Let him make his point. Yes, if he's let him make his point. Yeah, he wants to make a point.
He should leave, right? He's continuing with
You can counter him. Just give him a few seconds, let him make his point. Yes.
Okay, sir, please go.
And I believe Sanjeev Srivastava is also joining us on the debate. Yes, Alimuddin Khan, make your point.
Hi, Madhav, yes.
Madhavji, I am saying that Congress working committee and advisors of Congress president made the mistake, not Mr. Rahul Gandhiji made the mistake. There are advisors to Prime Minister also. They are advising him and he is taking decision. As Sajjad Saab said, no doubt about it. He should not blindly just believe them and just go ahead. He should have applied his mind. True about, I am
so
agreed with Sajjad Ji. But at the
statement.
Same time, I am saying that the decision of
it's a big statement. Alimuddin Khan, two Congress supporters as Rahul Gandhi acts without applying mind. It's a big statement. You should run it. It's a big statement. I love the acknowledgement that Rahul Gandhi acts without applying his mind. Such people should not be leading a party. If you can't apply your mind, you should not run a party.
Heckling anybody can do. I can also do heckling.
See, Sajjad Ji,
difficult.
I further state something.
Please give me one at a time. Ravi Shivastava, I'll let you come in. Just let Mr. Alimuddin Khan finish his
point. Part of being Congress president's responsibility is to apply your mind. It's part of the basic responsibility of being a party president.
Certainly, it appears at this point of time that this application of mind that Mr. Alimuddin Khan is going to talk about is certainly at some level, or if one reads this entire report, was somewhere missing. I want to bring in Sanjeev on this. Sanjeev, what do you make of this entire report? I want to ask you as someone who has been very clearly, let me complete my sentence. Sir, I've given you quite a lot of time to make a point. I will come back to you, Mr. Alimuddin Khan. Mr. Sanjeev Srivastava is also joining us now.
You have interrupted all the statements, sir.
Sir, I have given you enough time to speak, sir.
BJP is agreeing with you, sir.
All right. I'll bring you back, Mr. Alimuddin Khan. We have a lot of time on the discussion. It's a one-hour discussion. I'm going to bring in Sanjeev on one very crucial point. Sanjeev, now the fact is this, that if these were the wrong estimates that were being given to Rahul Gandhi, you know, was Rahul Gandhi gullible enough to believe them? Point number one. Point number two, his closest of close advisors who are giving him details, who are running his election war room as it were, or control room or whatever it's called, if those are the people deserting him today, you know, questions will be asked about Mr. Rahul Gandhi's leadership.
Okay, absolutely. See, the Congress party and its president Rahul Gandhi cannot run away with whatever the election results have been, number one. Number two, the fact that he has been gullible, the fact that the Congress party was actually expecting whether 184 or 165, but at least to cross 100 and be somewhere in that range where it can either lead a non-BJP coalition or support a non-BJP coalition. So all of that we know, and there were big errors of judgment. I think, to be fair to Rahul Gandhi, that is why he has owned up responsibility and resigned. And that is why he's also right now out of the country. And when he's going to come back, I think what is required now is that Rahul Gandhi, A, should stick to his decision of resigning from the post of party president. He should also stick to the decision of not appointing a Gandhi or not getting a Gandhi appointed as a party president. But what will happen is, so they need somebody else, a senior Congress leader.
Yeah.
Ideally, it should be one of the old veterans. Whether he'll be able to hold together a party or not, that's a separate question. But for a healthy democracy, we need the Congress party or any other party by whichever name as an opposition to the governing BJP. That's a requirement for a
No, that no one's denied.
Rahul Gandhi.
Can Rahul Gandhi choose the terms of who will be the next president,
his
the appointment of the
wrong.
Interim president? If he's resigned, he should leave.
His campaign strategy.
And the point is, Randeep Surjewala said, wo president hai,
he has left. Shehzad, we have not heard anything from him.
Sanjeev ji, with utmost respect.
No, Randeep Surjewala, that is wishful.
He said it from the official platform,
yeah.
Sir. And just one second.
Randeep Surjewala, a lot of people's...
Sir, just one second. Yeah. If he's left, Shazad, okay, let's assume.
Wish has been fulfilled.
No, sir, it's not my wish. It's actually not my wish. Let me make a serious point, sir. If he is serious about quitting, sir, he cannot take administrative decisions, which he was doing. Ahmed Patel's tweet said that he was trying to resolve issues in Rajasthan. He should have just let the process of a transparent, fair and free election to elect, not coronate the next president, take place.
Okay.
He clearly doesn't want to. He wants to keep a seat warmer there. He'll get some Antony or some old war horse to take the seat.
Okay.
And until 6 months till the media scheme
I think that's an important point.
Once again.
That's an important point, Sanjeev. And I'm going to bring in the other panelists as well on this. Sanjeev, if Rahul Gandhi was serious and he came in with, you know, this perspective of democratizing the Congress party, he's spoken about that repeatedly. Will he actually walk the talk on that promise of his of democratizing the entire process of selection within the party?
I think his whole talk of democratizing the party as Youth Congress and other leaders, that was also a big flop show. You only got, in Shehzad's words, Namdars getting to occupy those posts, because even in the Congress party, the elections are very easy to be manipulated because people have appointed their own PCC people, AICC people. So who will vote? You and I are not going to vote. The country's people are not going to vote. So all that thing, I think the need of the hour is that let the senior leaders of the Congress party, people with mass base, people with long experience, they should sit down, form a presidium, maybe an extended Congress working committee, and they should decide on who the next leader will be. If they get into an election mode, it will be further division, further barbadi in the Congress party. In any case, I don't think there can be more barbadi than what there is right now.
Okay.
But I don't think that is the way forward.
Somebody
non-Gandhi to
Sanjeev,
head the party.
Sanjeev, interestingly, people said the same thing in 2014. The same thing was said exactly 5 years ago.
Isse
zyada niche nahi ja sakte. And look at where we are in 2019.
But technically for 8 crores, they got 8 seats.
Bhai,
so 44 to 52.
We can be saying the same thing in 20. We can be saying that same thing in 2024 also.
Okay.
I strongly believe that in India, the next few years, only Vidhan Sabha elections will be competitive.
Okay.
The national election scene is more or less sealed.
All right. Ravi Srivastav wants to come in on this. Ravi Srivastav, the question at the end of the day is of responsibility. And whether it is the Gandhis, whether it is Rahul Gandhi, that responsibility has to be taken. I think that's the message that's coming out clearly from this entire report. Because it's not on one, not two, but on multiple levels that the failure has now been exposed.
Madhav, first of all, that it is not a new thing. The non-Gandhis have remained a president for the Congress party. This is nothing new. And some non-Gandhi will be appointed as a president for the party or a working president. That's nothing new. But what I'm saying, that all... No, sir, please don't stop heckling.
And
the point is that
your
giggling and laughing does not decimate a party which has got 20% vote in the country.
Sir, which has got 12 crore,
30 lakh
sir, आपने बहुत अच्छा परफॉर्मेंस किया 44 to 52 15% with BJP did not get sir, you have done excellent performance.
And I want to remind this lady with the BJP representative that you said Manmohan Singh UPA 1 and 2 what all things have been achieved in 10 years
sir, Mr. Modi could not achieve comment of one of the panelists who said Nehru was an Indira's legacy should have been highlighted their achievement should have been highlighted in 2019
you name one
but
thing.
When we tried to highlight Rajiv Gandhi's corruption, these were the same people who got a hard burn.
Internationally acclaimed economist, internationally acclaimed Manmohan Singh.
I absolutely agree with you, sir. And look what the Congress party did to him. He was an acclaimed economist, a leader of our excellence. But the Congress party and the Gandhis reduced him to a mere robot.
People even now.
That's what they did to him.
Even in NDA, there are corrupt people. Not one number of people are corrupt. Whom you want? You want me to name them? Not even corrupt. They're rapists and murderers are there in your party. Your terrorists are there in your party. Who is Sadhvi Pragya? Who is that Tawar and that
Sir, let's not start a debate.
Ravi Shivastav,
you have made very pertinent points and I agree that this is a very difficult debate for you to defend, but we are discussing Rahul Gandhi at this point of time. So I respectfully do not want to divert the debate into Sadhvi Pragya, but I want to go across to Alimuddin Khan. Alimuddin खान जी, मुझे एक चीज आप समझाइए कि चुनाव के रिजल्ट के एक दिन पहले राहुल गांधी जी एमके स्टालिन को फोन करते हैं, उनको कहते हैं कि प्लीज जॉइन एज होम मिनिस्टर. ही कॉल्स अप अखिलेश यादव, ही ऑफर्स हिम एन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, ही कॉल्स अप शरद पवार एंड आस्क्स हिम टू बी पार्ट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. सर, ये क्या हो रहा था? चुनाव के नतीजे से एक दिन पहले राहुल गांधी इतने कॉन्फिडेंट थे कि उन्हीं की सरकार आ रही है और रिजल्ट देखिए, not even a quarter, somewhere between a quarter and a third of the projected seats are what Congress actually won.
देखिए माधव जी, ये तो स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लानिंग होती है, हर पार्टी करती है, ये कोई बड़ा इशू नहीं है.
जो बड़ा इशू
ये है कि इस देश के अंदर जब तक ईवीएम पर चुनाव होते रहेंगे, इस देश में वन पार्टी सिस्टम रहेगा. ये फैक्ट है और इस हार्ड फैक्ट को मानना पड़ेगा. ये हार्ड फैक्ट है और हार्ड फैक्ट को मानना पड़ेगा. जहां तक कांग्रेस की गलतियां हैं, मैं आपको बताता हूं, मुझे बड़े रिलायबल सोर्सेज से पता है कि जब मीटिंग हुई थी सीडब्ल्यूसी की इस बात पर कि हार क्यों हुई, तो प्रियंका गांधी जी से जब डिस्कस हुई तो प्रियंका गांधी जी ने कहा कि हार के जिम्मेवार इसी रूम में बैठे हैं. तो यहीं पर बात खत्म हो जाती है.
नहीं तो वो बात वैसे कैसे खत्म हो जाती है? उन्होंने ये भी कहा,
रायबरेली में जाके कहा कि यहाँ सामने बैठे हैं तो उनको हार का कारण हमेशा सामने दिखाई दे रहा है, अपने अंदर उन्हें कोई हार का कारण नहीं दिखाई दे रहा है.
मैं एक लाइन में बोलूं क्या है प्रॉब्लम?
कैसा लीडर है?
लेट हिम रिस्पॉन्ड.
वो खुद भी बैठी थी उस मीटिंग में, वो खुद भी जिम्मेवारी उन्होंने ली. उन्होंने जिम्मेवारी खुद भी ली कि हम ही बैठे
हैं. कैसी जिम्मेवारी है जिसमें कि कोई अकाउंटेबिलिटी नहीं होती? सिर्फ जिम्मेवारी मौखिक रूप से डाल दी जाती है, ओनली शब्दों से जिम्मेदारी.
अकाउंटेबिलिटी ली गई, राहुल गांधी जी ने रिजाइन किया.
एक ही लाइन में मैं दया करूं कांग्रेस में क्या कर रहा है संजीव श्रीवास्तव, वो
गांधी
फैमिली नहीं रहेगा तो देश भी बर्बाद हो जाएगा, देश भी नहीं रहेगा. आप तो ये भी कह सकते हो इंडिया इज इंदिरा, इंदिरा इज इंडिया.
ओके
ता उम्र राहुल सोनिया प्रियंका
यही
गलती करते रहे, धूल चेहरे पर थी, ये लोग आईना साफ करते रहे.
ओके
द प्रॉब्लम इज विद देम, बट दे ब्लेम ईवीएम्स, दे ब्लेम मीडिया, दे ब्लेम बीजेपी, दे ब्लेम कार्यकर्ता, दे ब्लेम वोटर, दे ब्लेम वोटर.
नो बट अ लॉट ऑफ एनालिस्ट्स हैव ऑब्जर्वड, अ लॉट ऑफ एनालिस्ट्स हैव ऑब्जर्वड.
वन सेकंड आई हैव टू कम इन ओवर हियर
एंड आस्क संजीव अ वेरी पर्टिनेंट क्वेश्चन. संजीव, नाउ लॉट ऑफ एनालिस्ट्स आर ऑब्जर्विंग दिस एंड सेवरल पीपल हैव कम आउट एंड सेड that Rahul Gandhi may take responsibility, but ultimately we need a Gandhi, otherwise Congress party will implode, it will explode, all sorts of things will happen, there will be factionalism that will come out and the party will not be able to function together. So, you know, at the end of the day, What is your view on this? Rahul Gandhi has to take responsibility, but the Gandhis will continue to hold the strings from outside. You know, how will things go from here on? Shouldn't an example be set that the Congress party isn't dependent on the Gandhis for its future?
See, Madhav, the problem in answering this question is, A, I can take a very utopian principle stand and say that, yes, ideally, the Gandhis have failed to deliver in two successive elections and they need to take a back seat, which they should. But a Congress party sans Gandhis is also somewhere, I agree with Alimuddin Khan, that, see, you will have to give me 1 minute. The problem of the Congress party is, see, what is the Congress party? Congress party people keep saying that they are a movement. They were a movement in the freedom struggle. Since the 70s at least, the Congress party is a party which has no ideology. If you really ask a Congress person, bhai, tumhari kya siddhant kya hai is party ke, they will really start groping. They will come up with euphemisms and, you know, some kind of dialogues, but they don't know. Nobody knows what's the ideology of Congress party. Whether it's the B team of the BJP, whether it's a B team of the left of center parties. So nobody knows. So what if suppose there is no Gandhi, who will decide the infighting between a Jyotiraditya and a Kamal Nath? Who will arbitrate in the infighting between a Sachin Pilot and an Ashok Gehlot?
Yes.
Who will arbitrate between Amrinder Singh? Amrinder Singh, chalo, is all powerful. He doesn't need arbitration. Who will arbitrate between Bhupesh Baghel and keep that Deo, Singh Deo?
Who's egging Sidhu on?
Whether we like it or not, they also need a strong leader at the top,
okay,
whom everybody blindly follows.
Okay.
That's why they need a Gandhi.
I think you raised an important point. I want to ask this of Ravi Srivastava. Ravi Srivastava, before I come to both of you, 1 second, I just want to go across to Ravi Srivastava. Ravi Srivastava, the problem today is this. That Rahul Gandhi today, you know, his entire young guard who is, you know, facing struggles in different states. I think Sanjeev has articulated what has happened in Rajasthan, what is going on in Madhya Pradesh, what is happening in Punjab, what is happening in Chhattisgarh. It's there for all to see. It's a clear fight between the old guard and the new guard. And Rahul Gandhi today is not able to assert himself because with the perhaps a notable exception of Sachin Pilot in this Lok Sabha election at least, very few of his young Turks have actually been successful at the hustings. So Rahul Gandhi and his entire strategy of changing generations has not really worked on ground.
Madhav, just allow me one sentence. A Gandhi may not be able to assert themselves to resolve the difference, but at least they are saving the party from imploding.
Okay.
You know, they will just all drift apart. That is the problem of the Congress party. They have no love lost for Gandhis. They think they cannot exist without them. Otherwise, they'll fight each other and beat each other maybe to political death.
Okay.
That is the problem.
Okay.
So, they need to find a Gandhi-like figure, not a Gandhi.
All right. I want Ravi to come in on this. Yes, Ravi Srivastava.
Somebody whom they are all willing to
obey. Yes, you made your point.
Madhav,
I want Ravi Srivastava to come in and then I go across to others
extent,
for responses. Yes.
To this extent, I am in agreement with you that the old guards of the Congress party now have a time to sit aside and allow the young brigade to come forward.
Whether but young brigade to chunav nahi jeeti sir is bar.
Whether it is Murli Devra, whether it is Sanjay. No, they have not won. It is a different thing. Madhav, it's not so. Congress won election in panchayat election in Karnataka. Congress won panchayat election in Rajasthan. It is not so. You can't write off them. They are very much alive and they are very much on the ground. It's a party which has done a lot of sacrifices for the country. They have on record two prime ministers who died while on duty.
They have done
wonders for the
country.
No,
I appreciate your sentiment. I appreciate you're entitled to have your perspective and your sentiment.
You have
every right to do so. But ultimately, you know, in politics, the proof of the pudding is in the eating. You have to be successful at the polls.
Just to counter Sanjeev's point, Sanjeev is right. Sanjeev Srivastava is saying that the Gandhis are the glue that hold the party together, otherwise there will be implosion and infighting. There's also a role of the Gandhis, and Sanjeev can't deny this, that in some states, unnecessarily Gandhis put up these second number leaders to fight the first. Like in Punjab, they put up a Sidhu. They encouraged the Sidhu to go on his tail. In Maharashtra, Ashok Chavan, they got the Rajiv Satav, who is nobody. to go and create problems there. So it was done by the Gandhis. And why was it done? Sanjeev Srivastava has watched more politics than I have. The party was completely taken off of all mass leaders from states, regional leaders. They replaced them with loyalists who are family-run, small family-run kabilas. And the only way the big kabila could control the small kabila is when two kabilas fight, the big kabila would solve the big, chota kabila's problem.
Okay.
So they made it into a tribal Afghanistan feudal lord system. It never should have been that. It should have been a party for whatever's BJP's faults. BJP today still has a Shivraj Chauhan. It had big regional leaders who the party cannot ignore, and they are not there because they're loyal to the king. They
right.
are there because they are performers in their own right.
Okay.
Where is the performance in the Congress? There's no mass leader left in the Congress. They're only there because they're loyalist to the Gandhi family.
Okay. That's Ravi wants to respond to you on that. Ravi, no mass leaders in the Congress, says Shahzad Poonawalla. You want to respond to him on that?
Yeah, yeah. Please don't convert this debate into a Kabila fight. It's not a Kabila fight anyway. It's a very democratic party, and there are capable people in the party who can take it forward.
Okay.
There is no dearth of good people in Congress. Even
I agree.
Today,
appoint
I am telling
Captain
you,
Amrinder Singh.
It's not that there is a Kabila party or something like
it is
the Kabila
well,
party.
If there are popular leaders, certainly they should be given a bigger role. In fact, Sanjeev Srivastava himself has said. But I want Neha Joshi to respond to you on this question. Neha, the question
about all.
Okay. Infighting is a side issue, but many of them, I think, broadly agree that ultimately there is a role for a Gandhi in the politics of the Congress party, and that will not be changed.
Madhav, when two Congress sympathizers on the panel today invoke the freedom struggle and try to highlight Congress's role there, it actually reminds us that for several decades post-independence, the Congress got voted to power because that is what people associated the Congress party with. And like Sanjeev Srivastava mentioned, for the past decade or so, there is no ideology. Congress has essentially become a family-run enterprise, which is what it stands as today. So, you know, to say that, a Rahul Gandhi did not have the good sense to tell Divya Spandana, who's the official IT head, that do not tweet obnoxious, degrading memes about the Prime Minister from the official Congress account. You think this man is the only competent person to hold together the Congress party? This is the glue that you need to hold the Congress party together?
Okay.
God help you.
Okay.
They tweeted a meme of Nehru from the official handle.
Yeah.
And they paid 8 crores apparently for
it. Was doing all sacrosanct things. Do you are you aware?
So you know, if
okay,
I were a true Congress sympathizer,
I would be
boiling that 32 crores was pumped down to incompetent people. I see no word from Ravi Srivastava and from Alimuddin Khan that 32 crores of the Congress's money. It's not Sonia Gandhi's money. It's not Rahul Gandhi's personal money. Congress's party fund was thrown down the drain. Do you not feel a little bit of pain that money was misutilized? Do you have no questions of accountability of Rahul Gandhi, that he's sitting in a foreign country instead of fighting the BJP, and the BJP, which has won the elections, is actually planning how to win more elections? And my party leader is actually vacationing in London till his birthday comes along.
They never had.
He should be working doubly hard, and Modi should be chilling. But Modi is working doubly hard, Amit Shah is working triply hard, and Rahul Gandhi is chilling. And he's saying that
three
things wait.
And there are no
media, money and machine.
Yeah.
That's all.
Yeah, okay. Alimuddin Khanji, today the situation is this, that, you know, a senior leader in the Congress party, Mr. Veerappa Moily, comes out and says that the Congress party needs major surgery, not minor, major surgery.
Brain surgery.
Unka kehna hai ki party ki jo jitni bhi structure hai, organizational structure hai, it has to drastically be changed if the party has to go forward. And in fact, this is what he told us a few days earlier. That's not his statement of today that he gave to an agency. But listen to what Veerappa Moily said a few days earlier, and then I'm going to get a response from Mr. Alimuddin Khan.
Rahul Gandhi is still our Congress president. He has expressed his desire to quit and also make alternative arrangement in the Congress Working Committee. But it has not happened till today. But at the same time, in many of the state units, there is indiscipline, and people are also fighting each other in many of the states. That has to be stopped. Now he is the president, he has to stop it. And the democracy of this country is sustained only because of the Indian National Congress. We gained the independence. After gaining the independence, the gains of the freedom was given to the people by Indian National Congress. It is also a national duty to build this party, rebuild this party. Whenever there is a crisis, it is quite necessary that we need to, you know, the resolve the crisis and go forward.
Aliuddin Khan, many senior congressmen are today coming out and say they have to be drastic changes, otherwise the Congress party will not survive.
Madhavji, let me clear you one thing, that Rahul Gandhi will stay as a Congress president, number one.
It is he will clear. Stay.
Number two.
He will stay.
Congress need.
He will stay.
Yes, he will stay as a Congress president. He will stay as a Congress president and Congress will revive under his leadership.
Sir, trust me. Sir, 425
in 1985 elections. I have witnessed those elections, sir, also. Congress, sir. BJP has only won 303 seats.
No, that's
Congress
fine.
Congress only
no, no.
25 seats in 1985.
Sir. So don't. Sir, I'm not getting into history over here. I'm not getting into history, but Aliuddin Khan, the question is of accountability, of fixing accountability. So are you today going to come out and say that everybody else is responsible? Rahul Gandhi is not responsible. His image is Teflon coated and protected. That nothing can happen to Mr. Rahul Gandhi's image. He should continue as Congress president after all that has been revealed, particularly today's report. I am shocked that you are taking this position.
I am saying, sir, Rahul Gandhiji will remain as a Congress president, number one. All Mahamandaleswar will be sitting there and working there, doing
so
their
there should
job.
Be no accountability.
Only problem is with the
there should be no accountability.
Technical people.
Spanna, you are against accountability and responsibility.
All those things. Those people.
There should be no sense of responsibility fixed for who is responsible.
For this complete defeat
in the Lok Sabha election, there should be no accountability fixed. That's what you are saying, Aliuddin Khan. Rahul is not responsible for it.
Well, accountability is only. Accountability is there. Accountability is the advisor. Something wrong is with the advisor sitting with Rahul Gandhi ji in his 12 crore residence.
Rahul Gandhi is free to select.
I am not questioning winning of the BJP. I am questioning the margin of the winning of the BJP. And that can be done
sir,
only
you
by
questioning
machine,
the EVM.
Not by the mandate.
Sir, you are still questioning the EVM, which I am amazed at.
I am definitely questioning EVM.
If that's what the Congress party is going to work on, I really don't know what to do on this or what the party will do. I will come into Neha. I just want to give Sanjeev a hand because his hand has been going up. Sanjeev Srivastav, you're hearing these amazing arguments coming in today on national television as to what the reasons for Congress's loss are. We've heard the EVM. We've heard advisors of Rahul Gandhi. But no accountability needs to be fixed. No accountability needs to be there as far as the Congress president is concerned.
On the issue of Congress party's defeat, Madhav, I think the Congress really needs to understand what went wrong with them. Saying the EVMs malfunction, EVMs have been very consistent over the last several years. There's nothing wrong with the EVMs. So let's not blame them. B, the other argument which is constantly being put forward that it was just Hindutva which rallied Mr. Modi to pass 300 figure is also missing the woods for the trees. You know, Hindutva may have played a part, but there were many other factors. So we are not trying to get into that.
Are they fool?
But the third thing is that let the Congress leaders have the grace and the sense to allow Rahul Gandhi to step aside at this moment. If circumstances change, if people ever want, if Congress party really gets very desperate all over again,
okay,
at some stage he may come back if,
okay,
if
okay,
the
okay,
circumstances
okay,
so permit and such supporters a demand is raised.
Okay, okay. Once right now, let her come in. She's got a hand up. Yes, Neha, you want
to
counter that?
Just two lines, you know. Not I have no love for the Congress party and I don't care what they do with their organization. But you know, just a few days before counting, I was on your channel and you asked me, how many seats are you going to get? And I said 300 plus because my president said that.
Okay.
I know he has his eyes and ears on the ground. I know he has done, he traveled all across India. He's traveled to each constituency himself. That's the caliber and that is the reason why an Amit Shah is the president of the BJP. You have to understand that competence and merit is the only thing that should count in a democracy,
okay,
nothing else.
Yes. Okay, it's only competence and merit, yes. Ravi Srivastav, and then I'm going to come back to you, Shazad. Ravi Srivastav, it should be ultimately competence and merit that should rule the roost in a democracy. And why shouldn't that be the case?
I am not denying, but what I'm saying that under the victory by the means of media, machine and money, the BJP should not lecture Congress how they should function. They know pretty well that how to work, how to operate, and they have just 3 months before, when they won 3 elections successively of Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh, you did not say that Rahul Gandhi is not a competent person.
But that time
makes him an incompetent man if he loses the Lok Sabha election? How can you draw that conclusion?
Okay, sir, I'm going to let Shazad come in now. Yes, Shazad.
Ravi ji, aap hi se sawal, ek minute sun lijiye. Ek minute, agar EVM, media, sab log Hindutva, sab log zimmedar the, sun liye na. If ये लोग सब जिम्मेदार थे तो राहुल जी इस्तीफा क्यों कर रहे थे? राहुल जी इस्तीफा नहीं देते ना, ईवीएम ने हराया और ये एडवाइजर को क्यों गाली गलौज करते हो? या तो ईवीएम खराब है या तो एडवाइजर
खराब है. क्वेश्चन लिसन टू द रिस्पांस.
थ्री थिंग्स मेड यू विन द इलेक्शन.
अच्छा, नो, थ्री थिंग्स.
एंटायर सोशल मीडिया इज फ्लडेड that how the number of votes counted were more than the number of votes polled.
Sir, the election commission has responded to that. The election commission has responded. Those reports did not take into account the postal ballots, and they have taken the provisional figures from the election commission website as the final figures. Those are provisional figures which are there on the website. Let's not. I think we are doing a great disservice to democracy, to the opposition,
you see,
and to political parties if you're going to continue to blame the EVM again and again. Even Sanjeev Srivastav here has said exactly the same thing.
Ravi Srivastav and Ali Muddin Khan, when the entire Congress coterie, the core team is absconding, vacationing somewhere, these two gentlemen are bravely sitting here. I mean, I'm trying to defend Rahul Gandhi. I must say, I salute you.
There is nothing wrong in that.
But to his detriment,
there is nothing wrong in that. We'll go on the ballot paper. Yes. And you see the result of ballot paper. What happened in Karnataka?
Sir, I'm saying the institutions of this country can be blamed. People can be blamed. But Rahul Gandhi cannot attract any blame for losing election after election. He lost 50 elections. His mother lost the last election. But how dare we blame Gandhi? How dare you blame Gandhi? How dare you blame Gandhis?
You name the ED,
no other
you name the CBI.
Gandhis can lose elections, we can blame the people and the country. Can't blame
your
Gandhi
government has destroyed the institutions.
When Labour Party lost election after election, did they blame the leadership? They blamed the UK election system.
And I just want to come in. I just want to ask a simple question. I just want to ask a simple question of Mr. Alimuddin Khan. Mr. Alimuddin Khan, today, Rahul Gandhi has lost in his family pocket borough of Amethi after decades. A seat that has been in his family for decades, he has lost that particular seat. Why should he not owe moral responsibility for that, at least? His own seat. Is that the example that he is setting as a Congress president for other congressmen to win?
So what? Indira ji also lost election and then she became again Prime Minister of this country?
Oh.
And Rajiv ji got 425 seats in the parliament.
So what?
Sir, it is an election, it is a democracy. Democracy is in process. Only thing is we have to remove EVM from the system. We have to remove EVM from the system and election should be...
Sir, are you aware that Supreme Court... Are you aware that every time you have approached Supreme Court against the EVM, it has been rejected? At least half a dozen high courts in this country have rejected this demand of opposition parties who on various technical grounds have raised questions on the EVM. It's one thing if you question the election commission on political statements, but to question the EVM, sir,
to question EVM... paper trail.
And when EVMs elected Congress governments in 2004 and 2009, there was no
Supreme
problem
Court
then.
Decision is welcomed everywhere, but at the same time, there are political parties, they should do the mass movement. They should go and opt for the mass movement.
Sir, why mass movement? EVMs are
on
right, and they should ask the mass movement. Mass is there, it's not being reflected in the EVM, sir. I agree with you, mass is already there, movement is also there. It's not getting reflected in the EVMs.
All right.
The countries are doing election on ballot paper. Why can't we?
Sir, I think we should demand resignation from EVMs, not from
what?
Rahul Gandhi.
Both
I seriously think we should demand resignation from EVM
paper.
And from
Why
election commissioner for
it?
Congress party losing.
All right. I want a closing comment from Sanjeev Srivastava from here on. Sanjeev, the question that we've been asking, we've discussed, you know, dynastic politics. We've discussed the old guard versus the new guard. But where does the Congress party go from here? You're a close observer of the Congress party. And I just want to ask you one simple question today. If there is someone, you know, at least someone who's a proven leader who has at least a track record of winning elections in whichever part of the country it may be, wouldn't that person be the individual who would inspire more confidence as a Congress president at least today? Sanjeev.
See, a winning person, there are not many winning persons in the Congress party right now. So the young guard is all representing the dynasts, so they'll again be exposed to the charge of Namdas after a few weeks. So none of the chief ministers will be happy to leave the chief minister's job and become the party president. Otherwise, Amrinder would have been the best bet. So if the Congress party has any sense, they should allow some of the chief minister to remain the CM and become the party president. But that won't happen because they will not allow anybody to become so powerful. So what is the alternative? The alternative is, perhaps what I am hearing from Congress party, that they will get somebody from the south of Vindhyas,
okay,
where they have done relatively well. But again, south of Vindhyas, what are the options? And Anthony is too old and too kind of fossilified,
yes,
a person,
yes,
to become the party president.
Yes.
So then
well,
there
certainly,
is Mr.
Certainly, certainly Sanjeev, the options for Rahul Gandhi are very limited at this point of time. But certainly the mood within the Congress party is of a change as far as the leadership is concerned. And we will have to see really how things pan out in coming days. Sanjeev Srivastava, Alimuddin Khan, Ravi Srivastava, as well as Neha Joshi and Shehzad Poonawala, thanks so much for joining us on this debate.